So the change room is a two-year pilot project funded by the Movember Foundation. It's run by SAMH, the Scottish Association for Mental Health, in partnership with the SPFL Trust and Hibs Football Club. It's about bringing guys together. We're providing spaces where they can have banter, have a laugh, but also be open and address any mental health issues or challenges they may be facing.
I get involved in the changing room because for years I suffered with mental health illness. And when I heard about the changing room here at the stadium, I wanted to get involved, I wanted to share that experience with the men, and I volunteered to come and do a session, tell them about my experience, and any time I've been in here doing it, it has been motivational for me as well in my continuing battle with mental health illness, to see the men respond so well to my story and what I've been through.
Change Room isn't just for those that have had mental health issues or difficulties. It's something that is open to all guys aged 30 to 64. We recognise that we all have mental health, and so we all have a responsibility to look after it. And what better place if you're a football fan than in the football stadium environment? It's a community area that thousands of people come to every week, and we recognise that it's got a reach that can go much further than just 90 minutes on a Saturday afternoon.
The impact it's had on me is just, I know that I'm not alone. You know, I'm coming in and I know that I'm with a group of guys that everybody's going through the same thing as me. I know that I've got a lot of support there. It's just another support network for me, which is a big, big comfort. And coming along, enjoying the banter that the guys have as well is a great thing for me as well.
It's all about focusing on positive mental health, camaraderie between the guys, giving them a space where they feel comfortable, and just providing that environment that says it's okay to talk about your mental health, it's okay if you're going through a hard time. We run a series of activities and programs and courses that are all focused on helping men look after their own mental health, to build capacity so that they know where to get help or how to get support.
Being a first team scout at Hibs, one of my jobs is to read body language, and when you come in, quite often the guys are withdrawn and maybe a little bit nervous, and then I give my dressing room motivational speech and share my story, and by the end of it, it's really encouraging to see the guys opening up and their body language is opened up and they're looking much braver and they're actually chatting with each other. Some of them are actually talking about the problems that they've got and what they're facing, and they're discussing it with each other and asking me questions, and it's motivational to me as well to see such a rapid change in them just in the space of 20 minutes, just by opening up.
One of the things that stuck in my mind on the launch was Neil Lennon sort of saying the fact about, you know, mental health, people, you know, wise up, stiffen up, grow a pair, all these sort of things that you hear associated to mental health. And as a parent, when you're looking after your own family, as most parents will do, you do feel that you've got to grow a pair and be broad-shouldered and not show emotion. And then coming in here and meeting other people that are opening up, you suddenly realise that when you open up, yeah, you don't have to be broad-shouldered, and it's actually quite good to talk. And that's one of the big things I found out about it was, you know, very quickly I found out it was good for me as it was for Harry, and the changes in him, and I suppose folk have seen it in me too. Yeah, fantastic.
I first started as a participant for the changing room just to see how that would go, and so I did a sort of 12-week programme. It's helped me in quite a few different ways. I had a really sort of interesting incident with my son who plays football, and he came back from a game that they lost 4-0. And he was pretty upset about it and kind of straight into his room and didn't really want to talk about anything. So with some of the techniques I've learned actually at the changing room about kind of starting a conversation and talking to your family, I got his older brother and we got him out of his room. We went down to the park, kicked a football around, had a good laugh, you know, and then we went and got a bag of chips, you know, sort of thereafter. But just kind of the things I'd kind of learned in the changing room helped me to kind of think, what could I do to kind of like make that situation better for him?
It's the fact that it brings a unity between people, it brings a common interest, a common denominator. People are excited to come to Easter Road to have a coffee, to have a pie, have a blether, have a bit of banter. It feels like a privilege to be here and a privilege to help others as well.